sitting on the park bench.
It's only me.
now you know it's only on me. A little song to open up with, a piece of our personal history. It's a track I know you're probably very familiar with, a piece called Stairway to Heaven, or one of those that you hear on classic rock radio. The next piece is a lot more recent and a much more up-to-date song from a year or two later, 1972. It's a piece in which Martin Marr will play his flute. What do you think? Goodness me. With any luck, he'll get really good at this and then take up singing as well, and I'll just stay back there and make the drinks. Andrew Giddings is on keyboards tonight. Hello, Andrew. On bass guitar, Jonathan Noyce. He's only 16 years old. And all the way from Los Angeles, big boy Doan Perry at the back here. Hiya, Doan. He, as you see, is a little more colourful than the rest of us. Must have something to do with the West Coast. And this is called Thick as a Brick.
Really don't mind if you sit this one out. My words but a whisper, you never say
shut.
I may make you feel, but it can't make you think. There's nerves in the gut here, you love simple snake. So you ride yourself over your feet, and you make all your animals believe, and your wise men don't know how it feels.
To be thick as a brick.
Castle virtues are all swept away. In the tidal destruction, the moral delay. The elastic retreat rings are closer. They as the last wave uncovers the deep end of the way. Choose one of the eagles, and if sometimes I shaking your head, said it's a shame. Spend me that coming years and the days of my youth. You'd rather lay some black curtains and shout out the whole truth. Spend me down the long ages representing somehow. Thank you.
with a piece from J.S. Bach. It's called Bourée. Hooray for Bourée, and hurrah for Martin Barr. Actually, that's why I get to write the lyrics. There you go. This next piece is one from our most recent studio album, and it's a song about how you shouldn't chase those Arab girls, and it's particularly appropriate not to do that just at the moment. It's called Dangerous Veils, and we'll see you at the end of a frantic 5 minutes and 10 seconds or thereabouts. What do you say?
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. That was the Indian bamboo whistle, and a fine and extremely cheap instrument it is too. It's the kind I like. There was a piece called In the Grip of Stronger Stuff from a solo album I did last year called Divinities, and which is actually went to number one in the Billboard charts, which was tremendous, except that it was number one in the Billboard crossover classical charts, whatever the fuck they are, okay? Means you probably sell maybe 20, 30 copies, I don't know. Here's a song from 1970. It was actually Barrie Barlow's audition piece a long time ago, and I think it was Martin who said to me I should write a song about my hometown, a squalid, dreadful place if ever there was one, called Blackpool in the north of England, where I stayed only long enough to pass relatively successfully through puberty. Did not take particularly long either. So here's a song about this horrible, dreadful place you must never, ever go, and you will hear a rousing chorus in the middle of this, courtesy of the other band members who are going to sing for probably the fifth time in their entire careers. And only another 28 times to go. This is a nervous and tense moment, believe me. A one, two, three, four. I'm going up the floor, but down the smoke below. Taste me mum's jam, sardines, and see our antique glow. The candy floss salesman, watch his lateness in the sand. Down for a freaky weekend, in the hope that they'll be meeting Mystic Universe.
Don't you never know?
The Iron Tower smiles down upon the silver sea. And along the golden mile, they'll be swinging mugs of tea. The politicians there have come to take me there. While posing for the daily press, they'll look around and play the mess on every bed. There'll be pocket stays and they know goggles, muscles, brain and gaze. The sea beat and sand castles, highest in place. Deck chairs, rubber dinghies, overs, braces, dangling down. Sundance, stranded starfish in a haze.
Taste me mum's jam sardines and to see our auntie flow.
On the glass salesman, watching ladies in the sand. Down for a freaky weekend, in the hope that they'll be meeting Mystic Universe.
Will you never know?
There'll be buckets, pays, and bingo, goggles, muscles, brain, and chains. Seaweed and sand castles, ice and waves. Deck chairs, rubber dinghies, old best races, dangling down. Sand and stranded starfish in the haze.
Good old Blackpool.
Thank you. That was called Up the Pool from the Living in the Past album. And it's funny how you rediscover these songs years and years later and think, shit, we never played that one before. Now I know why. It'll get better. Trust me. Now, something quite strange is going to happen at this point, and it's something very rare in the career, the long career of Jethro Tull, that we can persuade our very dear friend, our very dear old friend, our very dear old and short-haired friend, Mr. Martin Lancelot Barr, to step to the microphone and speak to you. He's going to do it. Hey! Yeah!
Too kind. All those compliments, thank you. Well, Ian wrote a song about his hometown. Unfortunately, I couldn't find any words to describe my hometown, so I had to make it an instrumental. It's about a double-decker bus. It's off an album coming out September the 4th called The Meeting. And it has a little addition on the beginning, which isn't mine. Thank you.
Martin Barr. Martin Barr on lead guitar. There you go. Next one is a piece about a little girl lost temporarily, we hope, in the busy, treacherous streets of Bombay, where a life of child prostitution almost certainly awaits her, unless Andy Giddings gets to her in time. Such is the plot of this wonderful little song, Andy. You can save this little girl if you get there with the 50,000 rupees in your hand. This is called, and it's from the Rooster Branches album, a piece called Beside Myself.
Tragedies of pain.
myself. Beside myself.
Thank you, that was Beside Myself. A slightly more cheerful piece, set on that same dark and mysterious subcontinent. I must just say, isn't it nice to have Emerson, Lake, and I can't remember the rest of them. Emerson, Lake, and Palmer on tour with us. It's fabulous. Believe it or not, I never got the chance to see ELP back when, and we only just saw them for the first time at the beginning of this tour a few days ago. It's just so nice, isn't it, Andy, to work with a band who still have all their hair. Yeah. Bastards. A more cheerful piece set also in Bombay, now called Mumbai, officially on the maps. Time we went there, it was called Bombay, and in Bombay on St. Valentine's Day, people write letters to each other, published hundreds of them in the Times of India, saying lovey-dovey, wonderful, sweet things to their boyfriends, girlfriends, wives, husbands. It's just makes you want to have a shit. It's just so embarrassingly awful. But they mean well. And Andy Giddings, I think a little romantic mood from you would be appropriate at this time, and when you return home from this tour, why don't you marry that girl, huh? Why don't you marry Trumpy Trace? If you get married, you can have the wedding at my place, Andy. And we'll invite all these people. You want to come to Andy's wedding? Now you're in a hole. This is called Bombay Valentine. Thank you. That was from the songs from the Wood album, piece called Hunting Girl, about robust fun in the English shires and dales. Now, here's a piece from the Aqualung album again, a song about the old man watching over us up there, if he's on the case tonight. And you may even, Martin, be able to pull something off with your volume pedal and get it working again. Martin's not listening. Never mind. This is called My God.
You and me.
a poor man of peasant and a thief. If he had the rich man in his hand, who would steal the candy from a lamp in David's mouth if he could take it from the money hand? Cross that baby, gold is coming in again. Now she's trying to no contest, but she always pays again. She has been paying the village on its tax, now it grows. From the tag-time harbor, he walks around at Stewart.
To be thick as a